Really quick example of the blog index page and blog posts. Very easy to do. So the last few videos, we've been doing different things to this to make it a true developer's portfolio. And maybe you're the type of developer that likes to write out ideas or share different things in a blog. Let's go through and add that. And you're going to do it right along with me here. So I got my repository, the project running in the terminal here. I'm in the directory, and we've already got a layout. We've already got some CSS. We already got some components. Let's add a blog page. So we're going to do new file blog.astro. This will be our blog page. We're going to need a new folder called posts, and we'll work with that later. Let's also add the blog page to the navigation. So we go to the nav bar. We're going to add blog here. All right. Should auto update here. We see our blog page. It is empty because we have not imported the layout. Let's just get these components here at the top of our project page, and we'll fill them in on the blog page here. We got to add the layout, right? We got to add the title, blog, description. Maybe we don't want the app cards yet. Eventually, I want to display the blog posts in the app cards, like the projects and the apps. Let's see if this runs here. Okay, cool. We got a blog index page. We have it linked in the navigation. Step one, complete. Let's see. I think I want to keep it simple. I'm not going to do like a subheading or a section or anything like that. Let's stick with what we have here, where it's just the title at the top here. All right, so step one done. Step two, let's add our posts here. We'll do new file, hello world.md, and we're going to write the post in Markdown. So I saved the file as hello-world.md, and you'll see up here if I navigate to localhost post hello world, we see our first post here. So the first issue, right, is that we don't have our layout imported. I want to build out a separate layout. So within our layouts folder, we're going to build a new file called Markdown Post Layout. Okay, so now we have a separate layout for posts. So this layout is different than the main page layout because it displays, if we look at the layout here, it displays the title from the front matter as the H1, which is what we want. We can nest the post layout within the other layout so our site looks congruent and it makes sense stylistically. So this would be an example of a post. What I don't want, however, is two titles. We could either get rid of this one in the post layout, and that way we could still do stuff like have the body text. We can do stuff like we can add a list of tags and stuff like that. So that would be a reason why the post layout should be independent. Or I wonder if we could make this a optional prop. The title, make an optional prop here. All right, so really quick, I just generated some Markdown, and you'll see here we have all the Markdown stuff is working. We have a H2 here. What is Astro showing up correctly on the page? So this is a working post. We assigned it a title and a layout. We can assign it a description. This is a test post, and if we look at the source or we inspect and we look at the metadata, it should show the description. Yep, right here. This is a test post. I wonder about the title. Okay, so it is not filling in the title and the metadata. So I think for right now, what we should just do is just remove it from here and then just include it. So this kind of solves this. This keeps the title just like on the other pages, so it makes sense with the layout. And it also fills in the title tag up here. So this is an example of a post. Now let's go back to the blog index and have it find all of the posts within the post folder. We're going to just loop through all the content within the post folder and display it on here. So let's do that next. Okay, so now what we're going to do is just render out the apps card component, just like how we did on the other pages. We're first going to import it up here, and we're going to use the same three properties that we've used in the other pages. So there's a name, which is like the title, the URL, which is the link, and then the description, which will be the post description. So Just like the other pages, I have a UL to wrap the app card component in, and we're going to just use the same class app card list. This will allow us to, we can adjust this or change this for the blog post if we want to make it look a little different stylistically, or maybe we want to do like two columns. We can use this class to render two columns with like Flexbox or something. We're going to open a curly bracket. We're going to say all posts, which is what is being declared up here. So just really quick up here, we're importing, or we're really not importing, we're setting all of the contents within the post directory as a constant. So this is kind of like declaring a variable saying all of the posts in here, we're going to call all posts. And then down here, we're going to map it. We're going to just use posts as a way to define the properties. We're going to return the app card component. The app card component, remember, has three properties, name, URL, description. We're going to set the name as post.frontMatter. So this is important. This is saying use the front matter of the post for the title. If you remove this, it's not going to work because it's looking for a post title that doesn't exist. It's looking for something outside of the front matter. If you specify front matter, it's going to work correctly. Same with description, same thing. URL, it does not matter. We're not defining the URL in the front matter. The URL is going to be defined by the file path. So we don't need the URL to use the front matter. So that's it. This is the entire page. You can see it's very similar to the apps page. Pretty much the same thing. We could almost embed this whole thing in the layout. And then the project page, same thing. Project page, we define the types up here. But otherwise, the layout is very similar in terms of the wrapping the contents of the page within the layout and then defining the UL and then rendering the app card component with the properties. So yeah, here's our first post. Well, let's do one more, I guess. And Astro's really quick. It'll update as we're typing this out. Okay, and here's the first post. Here's the second post. Click on it. Goes to the next page or the second page. We click on this one. Goes to the Hello World page. All the markdown is working correctly. Let's try some Python code in this one. Yep, there's some Python. This is really cool that Astro, it looks like they include code stylings within their default projects, which is awesome. So I could do like, could do a little JavaScript too. This all works. So yeah, really quick example of the blog index page and blog posts. Very easy to do.